was talking on a number and digging on the radio. And then just across that Mississippi line, I heard that highway start to whine. Knew that left rear tire was just about to go. Well, the spare was flat and I got up tight, cause there wasn't a filling station in sight. So I just limped on down the shoulder on the rim. Went as far as I could and went to stop the car. It was right in front of this little bar, kind of a redneck looking joint called the Dewdrop Inn. I stuffed all my hair up under my hat, went and told the bartender I'd have had a flat. Would he be kind enough to give me change for a one? Well, that was one thing I was sure proud to see. There wasn't a soul in the place except for him and me, and he just looked disgusted, pointed toward the telephone. I called up a station down the road a ways and said, well, we ain't very busy today. We can have somebody there in just about 10 minutes or so. He said, now you just stay right where you're at. I didn't bother to tell the darn fool that I sure as hell didn't have any place else to go. Sat down at the bar and some guy walked in and said, who owns that car with the gun racks and the mag wheels and four on the floor? Well, he looked at me and I damn near died, and I decided that I'd just wait outside. So I laid a dollar on the bar and I hit it for the door. Just when I thought I was gonna get out of there with my skin, these five big dudes come strolling in with this one old drunk chick and some fella with green teeth. I was almost to the door when the biggest one said, you tip your hat to this lady, son. And when I did, all that hair fell out from underneath. Now, the last thing I wanted was to get in a fight in Jackson, Mississippi on a Saturday night, especially when there was six of them and only one of me. They all started laughing. I got feeling sick. I knew I'd better think of something pretty quick. So I just reached out and kicked old Green Teeth right in the knee. He let out a yell that'll curl your hair, but before he could move, I grabbed me a chair and said, watch him, folks, he's a thoroughly dangerous man. Well, you may not know it, but this man's a spy. He's an undercover agent for the FBI, and he's been sent down here to infiltrate the Ku Klux Klan. And he was still bent over, holding on to his knee, but everybody else was looking and listening to me, and I just laid it on thicker and heavier as I went. I said, would you believe this man has gone as far as tearing Reagan stickers off the bumpers of cars, and he voted for Jimmy Carter for president. He's a friend of them long-haired hippie-type pink old fags. I bet you he's even got a commie flag tacked up on the wall inside of his garage. He's snaking the grass, I can tell you guys. Now, he may look dumb, but that's just a disguise. He's a mastermind in the ways of espionage. They all started looking real suspicious at him, and he jumped up and said, now just wait a minute, Jim, you know he's lying. I've been living here all of my life. Well, I'm a faithful follower of Brother John Birch, and I belong to the Antioch Baptist Church, and I ain't even got a garage. You can call home and ask my wife. And then he started saying something about the way I was dressed, but I didn't stay around to hear the rest, cause I was too busy moving and hoping I didn't run out of luck. When I hit the ground, I was making tracks. They were just taking my car down off the jacks. I threw the man a 20 and jumped in, fired that mother up. You know, Cale Yarbrough would have sure been proud of the way I was moving when I passed that crowd coming out that door, headed toward me in the truck. Well, I knew I should have gone ahead and run, but somehow I just couldn't resist the fun. I chasing him on just once around the parking lot. Well, I headed for the cars and I hit the gas, spun around and headed them off with the pass. I was slinging gravel and putting a ton of dust in the air. And I had them all out there stepping and fetching like their heads are on fire and their asses were catching, but I figured I better go ahead and split before the cops got there. When I hit that road, I was really wheeling, had gravel flying and rubber squealing. I didn't slow down till I was almost Arkansas. Well, I think I'm gonna reroute my trip. I wonder if everybody would think I'd flip if I went to L.A. by Omaha. Thank you, Kenny. We appreciate it.